Have you ever wondered what are these small images called or how to create it? These are called favicons or favorite icon. So in this video, we're gonna create this. Hello everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, be sure to hit that subscribe button. Favicon is a small icon or image that is displayed within the browser tab and bookmarks bar. There are so many alternative names for it, such as favorite icon, browser icon, shortcut icon, tab icon, URL icon, and so on. It's important to note that your favicon needs to be square. The most recommended sizes are 16 by 16, 32 by 32 pixels. Why is it so important? It's important because if you have a favicon to your website, your user can easily identify your site in their browser tab and bookmarks, which helps your brand to build up brand recognition and brand trust. The most common favicon formats are ICO, PNG, and SVG. The ICO format is supported by all the browsers, and it's only the format that Internet Explorer 5 through Internet Explorer 10 supports. And if you talk about the PNG, it is also a nice format because it's a format that most people are used to. But the disadvantage of the PNG format is that it's not compatible with Internet Explorer 5 through Internet Explorer 10. Now talking about the SVG format. SVG format has benefit over the PNG and ICO formats, but doesn't have great browser support it. Only Chrome, Firefox, and Opera support SVG format favicons. So in this video, I will show you how will you set favicons to your website, but later on I'll show you how will you create ICO format favicons in Photoshop. I have opened same file in three browsers. If you look at the top left corner, you can't see any image or icon. Now let's go to the code editor. This is my HTML code. Now you can see there are three images. One image is with ICO file format, and one is with PNG, and third one is with SVG. Inside the head tag, I'm writing link colon favi. Okay, if you hit tab, you can get this code. Now you can see in the relation there is shortcut icon, in the type image slash x hyphen icon. So in the href attribute, I'm giving the location of ICO file format. So if I save the file and now refresh the browser, you can see at top left corner now there is icon. Let's go back to the code editor. So now let's set the PNG format favicon. image2.png, yeah, this image. So in order to set the PNG format favicon, first of all I want to change this links type to image slash png, and in the href attribute again I'm giving the image2.png. now let's save the file and let's refresh the browser. Now you can see that blue color purple icon. Similarly, let's set the SVG format favicon. First of all, let's change the type image slash SVG, and in the href attribute let's give SVG files location. Let's save the file, go back to the browser and let's refresh. Now you can see at top left corner red color icon. So in this way you can set the different file formats favicons to your website. ICO file format is the original file format for the favicon and is supported by all the browsers. So now let's create this format file with the help of Photoshop. Now I'm in the Photoshop. Since favicon is tiny image, I'm setting the document's height and width to 16 pixel. Now I'm taking the zoom tool, or you can press G. If you press and right drag, it will be zoom in, and if you press and left drag, it will be zoom out. Now let's import the image. And the image is, this image is PNG image, and I'm importing it. Now if I take the selection tool or press V and drag it out this image to my document, since the document size is too small, so press Ctrl T. Now you can't see anything. So now you can get the original size of the image by pressing Ctrl 0. by holding Alt key and drag your mouse and adjust the size of the image to the size of document. Now I don't want to I don't want this white background, so in order to hide, press that eye icon. Now you can see the checkbox, and now let's go to the file menu, select the save as option. Now give the proper name to your file. For the file type, I'm choosing ICO file format and press save. For the transparent image, I'm choosing PNG option. Now click on OK. I know that you may not have ICO file format in your Photoshop, so I'm giving the link in the description below from where you can download the ICO file format file and import to your Photoshop. So how to import to your Photoshop that file? Okay, so after downloading that file, go to the folder where you have installed the Photoshop, and inside that folder you can see folder name required. Inside the required, go to the plugin folder, and inside the plugins you'll find file format folder. So now you can copy and paste the file in the inside the file format folder. So in this way you can import the ICO file format in your Photoshop. And lastly, if you don't want this kind of lengthy process, you can visit different website where they will convert your any file or any image into your ICO file format. I have given one link to the website in the description below. So in this way you can convert any image to ICO file format. So that's it. If you have enjoyed this video, smash that like button. If you have any kind of question, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you are new to this channel, please don't forget to subscribe. Remember, there is always more to learn. So keep learning.